Hi, in this video, I'll cook different rice meals. Starting with a classic fried rice, I used basmati rice, which I washed 2 to 3 times till the water ran clear. This removes excess starch, which prevents the grains from sticking to each other and also makes it fluffy. Boil 2 to 3 cups of water over medium heat and add the washed rice to it. Stir with a fork occasionally to prevent sticking. I soaked the rice for 20 minutes, so it should be done cooking in 5 to 6 minutes max. Once the rice was done cooking, I drained the water and washed it with cold water to stop the cooking process. To a hot kadai, add 1 to 2 teaspoons of oil and let it heat. Following that, add ginger garlic paste and fry for a minute. Then add the white part of the spring onion and cook it for 2 to 3 minutes. Add cabbage, cook for 3 to 4 minutes before following with carrots and repeating the process. I know a wok is preferred, but I have a kadai which will do. I'll add recipe cards you can take screenshots of to summarize the video, so don't worry about it. Add in the chopped capsicums for the fragrance. Fry this for less than a minute so it doesn't lose its crunchiness and smell. Once the veggies have cooked as required, add in black pepper, white pepper and salt. Following this, add light soy sauce and rice before mixing to coat with the sauce. You can use day-old rice or make fresh rice like I did. Be careful and mix in folding motions to not break the rice. Garnish with green onions and ta-da! We are done with the fried rice. I feel like it's lacking something. So let's make a side dish. Shall we make chili potatoes to accompany the fried rice? Okay, let's go. Cut the potatoes into long strips like we do for French fries. But these strips need to be thicker than French fries. Now that I've sliced the potatoes in boiled water, I'll add a quarter teaspoon of vinegar to it and follow with the potato slices. Cook the potato for 7 to 8 minutes in boiling water before removing it off heat. Remember, we are not making mashed potatoes. We just need to cook the potatoes a little bit before frying. You can also skip the process and just dip it in a batter and fry it. Onto the batter for frying, add rice flour, black pepper powder, salt and water. Mix till well combined. You can also use corn flour, a mixture of maida and corn flour, or a mixture of maida and rice flour to make this batter. The batter shouldn't be very runny or it shouldn't be very thick that it sticks to the potatoes. It should just slightly coat the potatoes. Now that our batter is ready, coat the potatoes with a thin layer of batter and drop it into hot oil for frying. I'm gonna be double frying these potatoes. Drop the coated potato sticks one by one into oil to prevent sticking. Once the bubble formation subsides, remove and set aside. Turn the heat to high and after 2 to 3 minutes, drop the fried potato slices and fry till golden brown. Next, heat some oil, add in ginger garlic paste and fry for 20 to 30 seconds before adding in roughly chopped onions. Cook the onions till translucent and add ground chili paste to this and fry till the potency reduces. Add black pepper, white pepper and salt followed by the sauces light soy sauce, dark soy sauce and green chili sauce. Add water and sugar to this and bring to a boil. In the meantime, make the cornstarch slurry by mixing 2 teaspoons of cornstarch in 2 to 3 tablespoons of cold water. Add this slurry to the sauce mixture and let it thicken before adding in the potato slices. Toss and coat with sauce evenly. The rice with the spicy potatoes tastes delicious. It's a normal fried rice with a peppery kick to it. The potatoes were crispy on the outside and soft on the inside. Next up is a comfort dish in many houses. But this is my version of khichdi and it's flavorful. Not that the regular one isn't. First, I chopped up some potatoes and carrots, which are the only vegetables I'll be using in this dish. These pieces can be large as we are going to pressure cook them and it'll get soft and mushy. I don't know if this is a traditional khichdi recipe, but it works for me. Oh, I also have a bonus recipe at the end of the video, so keep watching. Once done with the veggies, I rinsed my rice and lentils under cold water. I prefer using equal parts of rice and lentils. Here, I used moong dal and toor dal. Sometimes I use a combination of moong dal, toor dal and chana dal. Once the water runs clear, it's time to get cooking. In a pressure cooker, add 2 tablespoons of ghee and heat. Add jeera and curry leaves and let them sputter. Add cubes of potatoes and carrot to this and toss it around to coat with the ghee. You can customize the recipe by adding vegetables of your choice. I also add in turmeric, dhania powder, red chili powder and salt. Cook these till fragrant and add in a handful of coriander to cook with this dish. After that, I added in the rinsed lentils and rice to this pressure cooker. Stir gently to mix. Pour water in the cooker and cook for 3 to 4 whistles. I think I poured somewhere around 2 to 3 cups of water. If you wish to cook this in a pot, add water and bring it to a boil before adding in the rice and lentils. Once the water boils, cook this covered for 35 to 40 minutes so they reach a soft baby food consistency. My khichdi was too thick, so I added hot water to adjust the consistency. The camera wasn't rolling when I did this, so just trust me on this, I guess. Garnish with coriander and serve with ghee and some sort of pickle. I just used pickled onions, that's all. You can eat it as it is, but the condiments makes this dish taste better than it already is. It's not spicy, but has a richness from the ghee that cannot be explained unless tried. Again, I do not know if the third dish can be called a pulao, but this is my version and to simplify things, I'm just going to call it pulao. Starting with a paste where most of the flavor comes from, it's similar to making a pasta sauce. Just substitute with rice instead of pasta. For the paste, I sliced onions and tomatoes thinly. I'm going to puree it anyways, so doesn't matter if it's thin or thick. I made a mistake while picking the rice. So I ran out of basmati and used a combination of basmati and sona masuri rice, which did work out in the end. For the basmati, I washed and soaked it in cold water for 20 minutes. The sona masuri was washed and added directly. While the rice was soaking, I made the base for the pulao, for which I heated oil in a pressure cooker and added the spices. Toss them around for 10 to 20 seconds, which is enough time for them to bloom. Careful not to burn the spices, otherwise it's going to taste bad. Next, add in the onions and cook till translucent. You can cook it till it gets golden for some extra flavor. Then add in green chilies, ginger garlic paste and cook this for 3 to 4 minutes. Follow with the tomatoes, which you can cover and cook. Tomato releases water, which can be steamed, so the tomatoes soften and cook. Add in sliced capsicum and cook for 2 to 3 minutes. This is an optional step but suggested for a nice flavor. Salt and cool this mixture, then blend it to a fine paste. So I'm a picky eater and certain boiled vegetables give me the ick, so I'm blending this mixture. In the same cooker, I added oil, cumin seeds, fennel seeds, potatoes and carrots. I want to cook these spices before adding in other ingredients, so I'm following this method. Then I added coriander powder, turmeric powder and red chili powder. I cooked this till fragrant and added in the puree. Then come the water and rice. I pressure cooked this for 2 whistles and let it cool. While waiting for the rice to cool, I made 2 side dishes. First, a soya fry, for which I started by boiling soya chunks in water for 20 minutes. It gets foamy initially, but this subsides as time passes. Once the soya chunks are soft, transfer them to cold water and squeeze out the excess water. This is done to remove the anti-nutrients present in soya, which may cause malabsorption and or gas. So to fry the soya, add oil in a kadai and heat it before adding mustard seeds. Add in thinly sliced onions and cook till soft before adding in ginger garlic paste. Cook the paste for 2 minutes. Add in capsicum slices. Then add in the spices and salt and cook till fragrant. Finish with soya chunks and mix to coat evenly in spices. Pulao is never complete without a raita. So let's make it. Take 1/4 cup of curd, 1/4 teaspoon kala namak, grated carrot, pickled beetroot and onions. Mix these together to combine. To make a tadka, heat oil and sputter mustard and cumin seeds in it. Toss it in the raita and combine. Okay, back to the rice. It got stuck to the bottom a little bit, but it's still edible because it's not burnt. It was spicy, but thankfully I had raita to cut it down. The chewy soya and soft cooked rice have different textures and it's yummy. You can use corn instead of potatoes and carrots to make a corn rice. If you add corn, the sweetness in the corn is expressed beautifully and it's not very overpowering. I told you there's a bonus recipe at the end, right? It's another way to make raita. For this, I used 1/4 cup curd, a pinch of kala namak and table salt, 1 to 2 teaspoons of pickled beetroot and onion juice, grated carrots and grated amla. If you don't like amla, this is a great way to have amla. I combined these before adding the pickled onions. A tadka is the final step in a raita. And for that, I heated oil and added in mustard seeds, cumin seeds and curry leaves. When it starts to sputter, take it off heat and add it to the raita. Mix to combine and ta-da, the raita is ready. Try these recipes out and let me know if you like it. I'll be back with more videos. Until then, bye-bye.